Alright guys, so welcome to Moss. I've only played the demo which I've had on my channel for the last few months. Seems to be pretty popular. So I thought I'd give that a cool game a go. It's like a puzzle platformer slash adventure game. You control a little mouse with a little sword made of a slither of grass. Bit weird. And you interact as kind of like a god or a deity. Bit strange, but yeah, I haven't actually played this full game yet, so let's start off. Unfortunately, it's a seated game, so I'd rather stand, but oh well. Use your DualShock 4. Grab and move. I've chucked subtitles on for you guys. Moss.
Your time. They called it the Cinder Knight. What came from those dark, starless skies would change the world of Moss forever.
Peace.
First.
Alright, honestly.
The Kingsguard.
Meanwhile, sorry guys, but I'm not fussed about the story. I just want to get into the game and then learn the story. Righty. Let's roll.
That hero, albeit an unlikely one, did arrive at a time she'd be needed most.
So, this looks to be the demo that we played is actually the start of the game. Well, it's this. There it is.
Quill was out adventuring beyond the edge of the clearing. Dusk was creeping in, but she wondered what she might find if she went just a little farther.
Hello there, Quill. Hello. Oh, what you got next to your foot? Come on. Oi, buddy. Yeah, this game looks gorgeous for what it is. Come on, grab what's next to your foot. Yeah, you should see my face soon enough. It's like a mask or something. And then I have to help little Quill at certain parts of the level. Solving puzzles, moving stuff and whatnot. Whoa. Wow. The 3D audio
is exactly
amazing.
Sure what she roused.
There you are.
But she felt no danger from the being silently peering
Hello.
Down at her.
Me. Hello?
Quill had to hurry. The village gates would soon close, and night would follow.
Yeah, so you move the left analog stick. The right one, at the moment, just doing nothing. Jump is X. Square is attack. Oh, what? In the demo, Quill had a little sword made of a blade of grass. Oh, why'd they get rid of that? That's sad. Now. This is definitely the perfect style game to hide secrets. Just hide them in behind. Stuff like that, why not? Whoop. Hello there, Quill. Hey, settle down, buddy. Alright, so this is how we interact with the world and help little Quill out. Hang on, this. Come on, there you come. Yeah. Quill approved. Nice little thumbs up. little bit, yeah. Hello. Okay, so it's not the same as the demo we played. Certain parts are, but other parts aren't. Does Krul have to come out of there first, or? Yeah, she does. Okay. So.
Night, her uncle often warned, was when danger was most present.
Really?
But Krul preferred the stories of the magical creatures that woke to protect the forest.
So how? Yeah? I know. I'm pulling across. Now what? So you're gonna go down there and grab it or something? Scroll up there. You have to climb right up top, do you? Ah, I see. The telltale white edges. There you go, hope you go across. Upsy daisy. Oh. A bit parkouring, eh? Now can I interact? No, damn. Whoop, scroll. Okay. Ooh, bronze trophy for something or other. Ah, there you are. Let's go this way. Hey! Can you go over there? No. Aha! Aggro little mouse, she is. I miss your grass sword. That was... And the whole game looked a lot cuter. Manlier. The aesthetic of it was great. Yes. Yes. There we go. A Krul. Don't know if that gives us anything, but I'm doing it anyway. Fine. There's crates, there's vases, you gotta destroy them. It's not a platform if you don't. Can I grab this? I can, but before you go there, I saw there is a little thing up here. Little scroll. Woohoo! Can I ring the bell? Damn, guess not. Yeah, for the controller plugged in because it's going a bit flat. Wasn't too prepared for this. Ow. I was hoping you could use the move controllers, but guess not. Oh, who's this? Hello? That mouse has got a hat. And clothes. You should feel ashamed, Quill. You're naked. God. For shame, Quill. For shame. Look, everyone's wearing clothes. And you're wearing what? A scarf? Can you skimp? Uh-oh. Apparently, mice can't swim. Okay. Oh, I'll remember that. Here you go. What is that? No mouse, is it? Can you? No? Okay. No, nope, can't go that door, okay. Hello, my mousy friend. Who are you? You're a bird? Wow. Still can't get over the visuals in this game. Oh, the whole game looks awesome. I know it's only like little areas, but... What was that? Hey, turn around. So... Run, crew, one. Now, why is there an extra step there? Ah, another way of getting over, I see. Oh, I gotcha. Alright. Now I've got it. Alright. We go this way, drop down here. Over there, up there. Up there. Up to Daisy. Up here. Carefully walk along there. There. And there.
Ah. Thanks to her new friend, Quill had saved priceless grains.
Oh no, 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 no! Sorry, Quill. Whoopsie. Yeah, my bad. There you go. I've died twice and I haven't seen one enemy yet. Well, I can
see
what's going
to
happen.
The door of the cottage she shared with her uncle.
You get to ride squirrels?
Once he saw her discovery, he'd lose himself in tales of its legend.
Oh. Squirrel riding. Yeah. It's literally my only goal in life is to ride a squirrel.
Uncle Argus was watching the evening light dim when Quill burst through the front door of their cottage. Uncle,
Uncle, there's something you have to see.
Out past the bell again, he scolded. Quill, I've told you countless times.
I know, Quill replied, crestfallen. I didn't mean to worry you. But I found something strange and magical.
Please turn over.
Quill trembled as she showed him the glass. What is it? She asked. A look of panic spilled over her uncle's stoic exterior.
Where did you find this?
Roared Uncle Argus. Quill had never seen her uncle so shaken.
Please turn page.
Just west of the clearing, she explained. And as soon as I picked it up...
Maybe your uncle's wearing clothes.
Something started helping me. Uncle Argus followed her motion.
A reader. With you, here, right now?
Mm-hmm.
Even with the moon full and bright, I must go right away.
Quill pressed. Where are you going? I can help. We can help.
No, he snapped. They'll find you and tear you apart. I have to go alone.
Alright, guys. Pretty sure I put this up. Okay.
It is for your own safety and for everyone here.
So does
in the clearing.
His long, heartfelt hug told her he was heading for danger.
I'll be back before midnight. Until I return, I need your word you will not leave the clearing with that glass. Promise me, Quill.
Oh, don't take the screw,
she said reluctantly.
I want to ride the
wondering
screw.
Where her uncle was going so deep into the night.
No fair. Now we're controlling uncle now? On the screw? No, damn it. Wake up. Oh. Get here.
Hey, kid. Kid. Wake up. Hey, kid, over here. I know where your uncle went. I can show you. You're twofold now. Very important. Bring that glass and your sidekick, too. We're going to need them.
I wouldn't trust him.
Quill called
him. Quill.
Hey!
Hello,
Sergeant,
hello, hello.
Wait!
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Aha! Didn't even see that up there. Ding, ding. Jump on the bed. Okay, let's go. Shoom.
Quill had never met a starving. In campfire stories, they often meddled in the lives of mortals. And when they appeared, mischief followed.
Really? I had to do it. Yeah, no, I had to. Alright, so there's a squirrel just here.
Passage through the eastern gate was strictly forbidden.
Really?
But despite her promise, Quill knew in her heart that Uncle Argus needed her.
Well, come on. Quill's running around in the nud. I don't think she gives a crap about rules, to be honest. No one come over there. What?
Quill demanded answers. Starthing, you can't just barge in here with your riddles. Where is he? What do you know?
Hmm. That's a little secret then. Guess not. Where are we going?
The trouble your uncle's heading for is the kind only you and that silent giant up there can get him out of.
Is that right? So... What the? Yeah, I don't know if we should trust this thingy.
This way, kid, urged the Starthing. And don't forget to tuck your ears in.
Okay. Full-size animals too. Whoops, scrolling behind the axe. Gotta get that. Balance, Quill, balance. Jeez, so high. Dude, that thing could literally eat you in one bite. So watch out. I can see the little hidden passage. Ooh. Don't bite me. Oh, there's a helmet. Go here. Which means you have to go up there. I gotcha. Up and around the back. Hey, Quill. Yes, I do. dun, dun. Yeah. Alright, let's go. Enough playing around. Awkward enough. Oh, looking at you. And then new. There we go.
Just on the other side is the mire, the Starling assured her. There's a good chance your uncle's still there.
Wee, buddy. Wow. I didn't even stop to look at the surroundings then.
Did you hear that? The Starling seemed anxious.
Wow.
I've ruffled enough leaves in these parts.
What is that?
I can't be seen with you. I'll catch up with you later. Just don't go and die on me.
A mouse statue or something? I don't know what that is, but... Devil. Oh, you stupid little... You're welcome. Anything hidden around here? Nope. Well, I can see. Whoa. Killer mouse armor. I need some. Enter. Maybe one is somewhere. Right up behind there. What? Okay, apparently you can not let it go there. Whoopsie. Once again, another death, and I haven't seen a single enemy yet. I just cheat and go up this way. Damn. So I'm like a god that can interact with the world. Why can't I just pick Quill up and, you know, just bonk, just go doop, stick Quill up there. Seems like a smart thing to do to me. Ah, I see, yeah. But I do have to get out of my seat occasionally. I wonder what other ones I've missed because I haven't actually sat up. No. Whoopsie. We just have signs, you know. Saying, hey, it's wet over there. Oh, I think I might be finding something. Maybe. Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, I remember you from the demo. Oop. Aha, take that. Come on, come on. Since I've vanquished my first lot of enemies, I will leave the episode there, I think. Might pick it up a bit later, get bored. Until then, stay sick, Quill.